हाय फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। इन दिस न्यू ईयर हमने अपनी एक शॉर्ट डे ट्रिप प्लान की है। वी आर टुडे गोइंग टू अ बर्ड सेंचुरी, रंगनथिट्टू बर्ड सेंचुरी, विच इज़ अराउंड 16 किलोमीटर्स फ्रॉम मैसूर एंड अराउंड 128 किलोमीटर्स फ्रॉम बैंगलोर। एंड दिस इज़ द राइट सीजन टू विजिट द सेंचुरी बिकॉज यू कैन सी मेनी माइग्रेटरी बर्ड्स, दो द नेस्टिंग सीजन एंड्स इन नवम्बर। सो जून टू नवंबर इज द बेस्ट टाइम टू गो। तो चलिए आप सबको लेके जाते हैं एक नई जगह, रंगनथिट्टू बर्ड सेंचुरी, सिचुएटेड इन श्रीरंगपटना, विच इज़ अ स्मॉल आइलैंड टाउन सराउंडेड बाय कावेरी रिवर। So we had started at 9 o'clock and it's around 10 o'clock, and another 2 hours and we'll be in the bird sanctuary. So we are at Kamath Group restaurant for a quick coffee and a bite. So my breakfast has arrived. I'm having idli, vada, sambar and chutney. And this is puri sabji and this is dosa. So breakfast done and now we are having filter coffee. So friends, found this very neat and clean place. So you can have a break here, have your coffee and breakfast if you are traveling towards the bird sanctuary. So now we have taken the diversion towards the bird sanctuary. So we are entering the bird sanctuary.
Left, then your destination will be on the right.
So we are going towards the parking. Parking is on the left. So right now we are at the parking and we can see a lot of vehicles here at the parking. So there are 6 islands and the main island is there and the bird sanctuary is situated around it. So this is Dr. Saleem Ali Information Center. Let's go and see what information we get on the birds here. This map shows the bird sanctuaries of India, and on this map you can see this is the place where Ranganthittu is. So here we can see the storks, the spoonbills and also one crocodile. You can see many crocodiles in Ranganthittu. Eagles, vultures, pelicans, egrets. This is the bird call tree. You can press the buttons and you'll come to know the different bird calls. So this is a painted stork. It has its wings and tail painted and a yellow color beak pattern. This is a crocodile and I've heard lots of crocodiles are there here. So dekhte hain aaj hame dikhta hai ki nahi crocodile. So this is the big pendant tree here, and this way is to the Maharaja Tower, the bird watch tower. So now we are moving towards the bird watch tower, meant for bird watching. So this is the Maharaja bird watch tower. There's a place to sit here, some benches here. You can easily sit here and watch the birds for hours and hours. So now we're climbing up the bird tower, the bird watch tower. So you have to climb quite a few steps. So now we are climbing up the bird watch tower, and it's quite steep. So this is the first level of the bird watch tower, and now we have to climb a few more steps up. We have to go up to the next level. So those of you who are scared of heights can avoid this, but I think this is the right place for bird watching. You can see all the nesting birds there. So at the back you can see some islands. There are around 6 islands, and these islands were built when there was a dam built on Kaveri River in 1600. So during that time around 25 islands came into existence, out of which 6 are a part of this bird sanctuary, Ranganthittu Bird Sanctuary, which is Karnataka's biggest bird sanctuary. And you can see lots and lots of birds here during June to November period, the nesting period. And of course you can always see them in the winter season, as many of the migratory birds also come here. In this water you can find many crocodiles, and these are the different islands, the 6 different islets or islands. Going down, you really need to walk very carefully as it's quite steep here. Watch tower we went up on, and you can sit hours and watch the birds. So in this bird sanctuary, not only you can see birds, you can also see crocodiles, then monkeys and some other animals, and also a lot of trees, a lot of greenery. So now let's go around the bird sanctuary and do some boating and show you the birds. This bird sanctuary is quite well maintained. You can see a lot of Indian cliff swallows here, and from December to April is their nesting period. This is a night heron, and it is distributed throughout India, and it is found in lagoons. Bird which is found here in abundance is little cormorant, and the nesting period is from November to February. Booking tickets here, way to the ticket counter. And we have already taken the tickets. Boating tickets cost 70 rupees per head, but you have to go on a shared boat. So now we are going to line up for the boat. So here we are waiting in a line for the boat. So only few people can go at a time. So we're waiting for our chance to go in the boat. So he's sanitizing all the life jackets here. We go boating. I wanted to show you a nest on the tree. The nest made by the birds. and I don't know how do they balance on the top of the trees. So here you can see the boats, people slowly climbing into the boat. So now we are inside the boat. This water is full of crocodiles. So right now we are on the boat and we are going to see a lot of birds. This is the nest of pelicans. They are feeding their babies. Make it stop, yeah. They're all painted stalks.
This one all bald nesting time and the nest mein baithe hue dekhne yaad karta hai do teen inch hai andar ye marsh dot ira le lo kam
they hatching the eggs.
Night
era. These are the spoonbills. Beautiful crest on the head. You can see the crocodile here. Three crocodiles, huh? See. Wow. ये अच्छे birds हैं. Never thought we'll see so many birds. Thank you. there's a boating point here and a rock garden. And this is the way to get out of this sanctuary. So this is the way to the watchtower. This is a souvenir shop which is closed. So the three main things to do here is visit the Dr. Salim Ali Center for information, where you will collect a lot of information on the birds. Then the watchtower, you can see the birds very clearly from the watchtower. And the boating is a must. We saw so many birds. Actually, we didn't expect we'll be seeing so many birds, but this is the nesting period and many migratory birds have come. A newly constructed garden. Actually, you can spend a lot of time here if you're a bird lover, and you can watch a lot of birds during the nesting season. As well as they have beautiful gardens here where you can spend time with your family. The souvenir shop was closed. The boating is going on right now, and also the watchtower is open along with the information center. So there's a lot to do here. Actually, when we came here, we never thought that you'd be seeing so many birds and the crocodiles. There are hundreds of crocodiles in the water there. And we saw egrets, we saw spoonbills, we could see the Asian stork, the painted stork, the pelican, and also the egrets. So this is a wonderful time to come here. We covered most of the places in this bird sanctuary. Now we are heading towards the Tipu Sultan's summer palace, which is around 4 to 5 kilometers from here. So jab hum yahan hain to chaliye wo bhi dekh lete hain. Maybe I'll cover it in the next vlog. So now we're moving towards the exit. It's a beautiful bird sanctuary, and this is the best time to visit the sanctuary. Please do come over if you have time. So there's a small canteen here and some vendors selling popcorn and ice cream. This is the cafeteria I was talking about. Small canteen area where you can get snacks, sweet corn, popcorn, and I think on top you can get some tea, coffee and snacks. So it's written that outside eatables are not allowed. So friends, maza aa gaya ye bird sanctuary dekh ke. It's a must visit place, and one of the best bird sanctuaries that we have seen in India. Now we are heading towards the Tipu Sultan Summer Palace, which is located around 4 to 5 kilometers from this bird sanctuary.